First, though, a shocking medical condition you've quite likely never even heard of. That said, every week it kills 10 fit and healthy young Australians, mostly teenagers. I know that sounds absurd, but it's both terrifying and true. Commonly known as sudden death, the only symptom is usually death itself. Here's Max Futcher.
It's actually a nice day, yeah.
At just 19 years old, Kieran Fielding is lucky to be enjoying the sunshine. Last Monday morning, his mum went into his bedroom and found he wasn't breathing.
And he was lying in bed. I could see he was blue. He was unresponsive, and I thought I'd lost him.
All I remember was just waking up and just vision really blurred.
Kieran's mum saved him by minutes, but 3 years ago, the family wasn't so lucky. In 2008, when Cheryl went to check on Kieran's older sister, Tara, it was too late. There was no warning, no explanation.
It was my quest to find out. You know, on her death certificate, they put natural causes. And I said, it's not natural to die at 18. I want to know.
She discovered 18-year-old Tara died from sudden arrhythmic death syndrome, a genetic condition affecting younger people, creating abnormal heart rates, which can stop blood pumping to the brain. No one saw it coming.
These are young, fit, healthy, well-looking young people who present for the first time with a sudden death. Parents universally ask two questions: why did my son or daughter die suddenly, and how can we prevent this ever happening to anyone else in our family?
Those were the exact questions Cheryl Fielding was asking, and last week she and Kieran got the answer: an implanted heart starter.
And these are devices which are implanted into the chest of the young person and detects the heart rhythm every beat of every day. And if it goes into a rhythm that could lead to sudden death, it delivers a direct shock to the heart and saves the young person's life.
And what's it feel like having that in there?
You can definitely notice it. I mean, you definitely can't see it, but, you know, if you do that, then it's there.
Yeah, and you can feel the pulse?
Yeah, like a moment ago, I could definitely feel it pacing me, yeah.
Just now?
Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
And again, it's like, oh, it's pacing me, but it's a good thing.
It's almost like the device is protecting Kieran from a condition best described as SIDS for young adults. Now they've started spreading the word through a campaign warning others to be on the lookout for signs and get tested.
You know, things like unexpected breathlessness, pains in the chest, fainting, unconsciousness.
It's estimated 10 young Australians a week, about 600 a year, are dying from this condition. But in truth, it's certain to be many more than that because so often it goes undiagnosed.
I had some cardiologists say to me, you've got a fit, healthy boy, why are you worrying? And I used to say, well, I had a fit, healthy girl.
Kieran is looking forward to the rest of his life and he knows he has Tara to thank.
Life is too precious, too short. Take every moment.
I'm sure she's looking down and saying he's safe. I think we've learnt so much from losing Tara that she's protected her brother.